Hello guys, so in this video I'm going to show you how we can create this Google sign-in app with MIT App Inventor. So we are going to use here one extension. That extension name is extension to sign in with Google account. Okay, so using this extension we are going to perform this action. Now the thing is, with this extension we need to do some customized coding. Customized coding means, you know, you have to open the browser in your app, and then you need to use some designs also. So this developer have done amazing job and he is providing us the AIF file. So what we need to do, we need to use this AIF file. Okay, just download this, and we need to use our own credential. Okay, we need to use our own credential. So just download this AIF file. Let's go to the MIT App Inventor, import the AIF project, click on choose file. Okay, so just import this. Okay, now whenever we start creating the app like this, so make sure you can use this existing code, okay, for the Google sign-in process. Then now we need here credentials, we need authentication key. This is the most important. See, this developer have the amazing, fantastic job. He used the custom web view. Okay, he used some other extensions also for the designing purpose. Okay, and let's go to the blog, and he has done the amazing, the coding also, that's amazing. But what we need to do here, this the thing is required, that's the most important is, for this is the client ID and the client secret. We need it. How can I get that? Okay. It's really very easy. So let's do then Google Cloud Console. We need to just search Google Cloud Console and just click on this. See, as you can see here, you're working in this project. Like, see, you can find your project like this. If there is no project, so you will find the create project option. So now, as you can see here, you can find the my project option. So click on this. Now in this, find new project. See, so now click on the new project option here, and we need to, you know, user name. So you can use like my project 35, or like you can say the app inventor or something. Okay, and now let's click on the create option, and make sure it cannot be changed later. It means you can't change this. So make sure, if you are creating the project for Google sign-in, if you are creating the project, whatever project you are creating, make sure that name should be the same, similar to our app. Okay, this done, selected project. So just select this project. You can select this project from here, or you can select this project from here also. You will find your multiple project that you have created. Now what we need to do here, in left side you'll find navigation menu, click on this. Okay, and now here you can see the API and services. Okay, and see the enable API and services, click on this. Now we need to enable one API, and that name is people API. Wait some seconds and you will find one dashboard. See this one, so you can see the enable API and services. So click on this. From now you need to search here people people API, like this. Okay, and just search it and see the Google people API. Just click on this, and now we need to enable this API. Okay, so just click on the enable option. It's done. Now we need to create the credentials. Okay, so in the left side you'll find the credentials option. Okay, but before this we need to use the auth consent screen. So first click on this auth consent screen. Now as you can see the internal, external, so we'll use the external, then just click on create. We need to put the app name, so you can put the app inventor, app, use the support email ID. Okay, and see the developer contact information, make sure that should be the different. Okay, so I'll use another. Now just do the thing like save and continue, don't do anything, just save and continue, and just back to the dashboard. Okay, now this is done. Now make sure that we need to publish app, so click on publish app and just confirm it. Now let's go to the credential. Once I select this one, so this will not ask me a lot of things. So I'll use this one because we just need a ID. Okay, so you don't need to worry about that. So just create this. So now we have the client ID and secret ID. So copy the client ID, go to the MIT App Inventor project, and this is the client ID, paste it here. Go back, then client secret, go MIT App Inventor and paste it here. And that is done. Now after the, you know, getting the input, you will get the information. Okay, now you can do what you can do here, you'll find that there's only one screen. So whenever someone sign in, if sign in successful, or you got some contact number or name, then you can redirect them to the another screen. Okay, so this is really amazing and simple. So if you have any doubt, you can ask in comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.